Chris, did the Clippers show last night that they are, in fact, better than the Lakers?
Look, you guys know I think that the Clippers are better than the Lakers. And obviously, we'll find that out in the next round. And last night, they proved that their defense is stifling. All right, to hold Denver, who's one of the most efficient teams offensively in the league, to 39% shooting, to take Jamal Murray out of this series. They've shown Jamal Murray what the difference is between pretty good teams and elite teams. And he is struggling at the next level. Okay, so defensively last night, they were great. But I can't say they proved yet or last night even that they're better than the Lakers. Because on the offensive end, outside of Kawhi, they struggled. Paul George, who was very good defensively, had 10 points. Lou Williams shot 3 for 11, and Lou is averaging 9 points over the last 6 games. He's shooting, believe it or not, 9% from 3-point range over the last 6 games. He still hasn't come out of his bubble funk. And so they're a bit inconsistent. Now, they're still winning games. I still believe in them, but I don't think they've proven yet that they're better than the Lakers. What I'm trusting in is I'm looking at their roster, and I'm saying, look at that depth. I'm saying you've got Kawhi and Paul George to throw at LeBron James. You got Marcus Morris, who I think will do a very good job on Anthony Davis. And then when you need that third guy to step up, I'm sure that a Clipper will step up, basing it on the track records, whether it's Lou, whether it's Montrezl Harrell, whether it's Morris, you know, Landry Shamet even can hit some shots. I'm not sure of the Lakers' third guy. And I know playoff Rondo has shown up, but can we really count on that in year 14 at 34 years of age? So I have just more certainty in the Clippers' depth when I look at them on paper. But I would be lying if I said, based on what I saw last night or even throughout the playoffs thus far, that they've proven to me, oh, they're definitely better than the Lakers. Right now, I'm looking at it 55% Clippers, 45% Lakers in the next round.
But you're mainly looking at it because of the depth, not because of the overwhelming play that you've seen. You just think they're a deeper team, can throw more bodies at LeBron, and if LeBron is off the court, he gets in foul trouble for some unforeseen reason, you trust their bench more than you trust the Lakers bench.
Right. And I think the Lakers haven't been as consistent either. So I think both teams have been a little bit up and down. But, yeah, Shannon, you summed it up well.
When I look at it, you know, the Nuggets only scored 85, but the Clippers only scored 96. So what about them? They shot 42%. That's not good. And when you look at it, the Nuggets are very predictable. They dribble handoff. They put Jokic at the high pick, and they dribble handoff. They pass it to him, and then here come Murray. They dribble the handoff to him. And, look, Michael Porter Jr., I think he could have got more opportunity than what he got last night. He was a very good third option in the first half. And you're right. Jamal Murray, to take that next step, bruh, these are the games you got to shine in. I mean, yeah, you did what you did against Utah, and you helped them advance. But beating Utah, yeah, that gets you a little cred. You got to do it against the big boys now. You got to do it against the Clippers. You got to do it against the Lakers, because as the stage rises, you need to rise with it. And we haven't seen him do that. Joker's doing Joker things. He was another 26-11 last night with 6 assists. But you're not going to beat the Clippers with one guy. That's not going to happen. You need two, potentially third. Because remember, Chris, when they played, I think, the last game before the Clippers and the Lakers played, they got a third guy in Avery Bradley. AD did what he did. LeBron did what he did. And you're going to need the third guy, kind of like the other night against the Rockets. LeBron did what he did. AD did what he did. And then here come Rondo, and even Kuzma chipped in. So I just think the thing is that you look at the Clippers, they shot 29% from the three. They shot 42% from the field, 73% from the free throw line. So for me, I'm not looking at them like they're the 2018 Warriors. I'm not looking at them like they're the 86 Celtics. They're beatable. So stop this notion, because we saw Kawhi go 4-17, and then he went horrible the next night and then score, what, Skip, you remember? He went one fourth quarter. Chris, you remember that? He would score 0 points. In the fourth quarter, had 13 points on 4-17 shooting. And then he followed that up with a 1-for-7 in the fourth quarter. But Skip don't want to talk about that. But my guy just keep on doing Goldie's thing. Mm. But I'll see you Monday, Chris. Tune in. Make sure you tune in Monday. I'll be out here in a centaur uniform in honor of Goat James.
All you got, Shannon.
Look at the Mamba jersey. I got one coming, too.
Shannon, do you remember the old cliche about you're whistling through the graveyard? You're whistling because you're afraid you're going to see your own ghost rise up for one of those graves. And the truth is, right here, right now, the Clippers are digging the grave that your Lakers are going to wind up in the next round.
Okay.
You saw what they do when they decide on defense. You saw the first quarter, you saw the third quarter, and you saw a stretch of the fourth quarter. When they decide, they suffocate you.
Thank you for watching. You can subscribe here to get the latest from the show, and be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed, or go watch a few other segments from our other shows on FS1.